It's never been easier to create responsive layouts that look beautiful on every screen. In this three-part mini-series, I'll be showing you how to build this front-end mentor project from scratch. In this video, I'll be building out the article list using a flexible grid. So if you're ready, fire up your favorite editor and let's code. For this video, I'll be focusing on the article list of this landing page. For now, I'll comment out the heading and hero sections above, just to make sure things are clear while I build. Inside the article list section, I'll add an H2 for the heading and give it the screen reader only class I created in the first video. This will hide the heading from view, but keep it in the accessibility tree for screen readers. Check the description below for links to the first video in this series where I created this class. Next, I'll add three article tags, each with a class of card. I'll add the image for each card, leaving the alt attribute blank since these images are decorative. Then I'll add a div with a class of card body. This is where the number, link, and paragraph text will live. To make styling easier, I'll wrap the link and paragraph in a div. Now that we have the markup complete, let's style up this section. First, I'll add a max width to the image. Then I'll add font sizes, font weights, and colors to the number and links. I'll also add hover and focus dates for the links. Lastly, I'll add margin to the bottom of each link. Next, I'll lay out the card using display flex, adding space between the image and text using the gap property. Then, to space out the number and text, I'll add display flex to the card body and change the flex direction to column. I'll set the justify content property to space between to push the number and text to opposite ends of the flex container. The layout for this section is similar to the layout of the header and hero sections. Check the description below for links to those two videos. For this section, I'll be creating a three-column grid. The two outer columns will act as margins. The inner column will hold the content. To set up the grid, I'll add display grid to the article list. I'll use grid template columns to specify the sizing for each column. I'll give the two outer columns a minimum size of 1 rem and a maximum size of 1 fr, or one fraction of the total available space. According to the design specs, the desktop view is considered to be 1440 pixels wide, or 90 rem. So this will be the maximum allowed width for the content. I'll assign a max size of 90 rem to the second column and a minimum size of 0. Now I can place the direct children of the article list into the grid column from lines 2 to 3. I'll also add some margin to the top and bottom of the article list to space things out a bit. Now that the section layout is complete, let's lay out the individual articles. To lay out the individual articles, I'll use a flexible grid. The flexible grid was introduced by Stephanie Eccles. Check out the links below to read her article on the subject. In this layout technique, I'll create columns using the repeat function. The repeat function takes two arguments, a track list and the number of times the track list should be repeated. A track list is just a list of column widths. For example, if I wanted to create three columns, I could specify a repeat value of 3 and a track list or column width of 1 fr. My content is then automatically flowed into each of the three grid cells. If I wanted 4 columns, I could increase the repeat value to 4. I could create the same 4 columns by specifying a repeat value of 2 and a track list of 1 fr, 1 fr. For now, I'll stick with the three columns the design requires. But as you can see, at a certain point, the layout breaks because I've locked in the number of columns. Ideally, as more horizontal space becomes available, I want new columns to be added to the row. And as the horizontal space decreases, columns should collapse and content should be placed in a new row and column below. Thankfully, using the autofit keyword with the min-max function, we can do just that. I'll add the min-max function with a min value of 350 pixels and a max value of 1 fr. This is telling the browser that each track or column should be no smaller than 350 pixels and take up a max of one fraction of the available space. Instead of specifying an integer for the repeat argument, I'll use the autofit keyword. Autofit tells the browser to fit as many columns of the specified size as it can within the row. As soon as there isn't enough space to fit, in this case, three columns of 350 pixels, then the last column will collapse, sending the content to a new row and column below. In this new two-column view, each column now has enough space to take up its maximum size of 1 FR. As the viewport continues to shrink, the columns will adjust their widths until they reach the minimum size of 350 pixels. Again, the last column will collapse, sending the content into a new row and column below. As expected, the reverse is true when the viewport widens. As more horizontal space becomes available, a new column will pop into the row above, bringing the content with it. And there you have it, a flexible grid that adjusts to fit the size of the viewport. And with that, this front-end mentor project responsive landing page is complete. Grid makes it super easy to create gorgeous responsive layouts that look good on every screen. And in case you missed them, check out the first two videos in this series where I build out the header navigation and hero sections. Hey everyone, thanks for watching and be sure to subscribe for more CSS builds. Until next time, happy coding!